everybody. This is Christopher with AG Productions, and welcome to this week's edition of Ask a Painter, where I take some of the questions that come up more frequently in the emails that we receive, and we answer them on camera. That way, neither myself nor Annie has to write 15 different emails to people. All right, so several questions we're going to go over this week. Hopefully, we'll be able to cut them down to fairly short answers. I know recently in all the Ask a Painter episodes, they've been going kind of lengthy because most of them are sort of open-ended opinion-style questions, but really only one of those comes up today. So, let's get right into it, shall we? Question number one, what's your take on Reaper Pro paints? Very good question. Unfortunately, my opinion no longer matters because Reaper Pro paints have been discontinued. However, I will tell you this. If you can get your hands on them, they are extremely high-quality paints. Highly recommend them. Every single pot that I have ever used has been absolutely fantastic. They're just a great, great set of paints. I really wish that they had not discontinued them and instead of producing this new line of Master Series paints that they have, they had maybe repackaged the Pro paints into the eyedropper bottles and just had a separate line for the Pro paints. But unfortunately, it's just one of those things. It's kind of like, Games Workshop's like Mordheim, for instance. Cool game, lots of really nice figures, but to be honest with you, if it doesn't get the support from the manufacturer, it's not going to get the sales. When they don't see the sales come in, guess what? Line's going to get dropped, okay? So it's basically the same thing. Reaper really didn't give the Pro paints a lot of support. They really pushed the Master Series paints, and because of that, unfortunately, the Pro paints are no longer available. I really wish they were. Maybe one day they will re-implement them. They've actually already re-implemented them one time. They discontinued them when the Master Series paints came out and then reinstituted them with an entirely new line of colors. But, again, great paints, but unfortunately just didn't receive the backing that the Master Series paints had, and to be perfectly honest with you, most of the people out there didn't even know that Reaper had any paints other than the Master Series paints, which is quite sad, unfortunately. But anyway, if you can get your hands on them, maybe on eBay or something like that, definitely pick up a couple of pots of the Pro paints because they're very, very good paint. Next, are you ever going to do another speed painting contest, or any contest for that matter? Yes. And yes, the speed painting contest, odds are October is what we're shooting for on that one. That's what we did last year, was an October contest. I've been hesitant to run another contest. Number one, because of the lack of entrance into the normal painting style stuff. But at the same time, I do want to push the painting hobby. And so, more than likely, and don't hold me to this, but more than likely, you'll see a contest that begins probably early August and ends at the end of August. And then you'll hear the announcement for the speed painting contest probably early October, and then that will end on Halloween. But, yes, there will be more contests coming. The intent, again, was to do like 4 or 5 contests over the course of the year. But because of stuff that happened and things getting shoved around, that didn't happen. Perhaps next year. We'll see. Alright. Next. Here's a good one. This came up a lot at Origins. I cannot count the number of people that came up to the booth where I was sitting and said, you know, I'd love to learn how to paint, but I just can't keep my hands and my arms from shaking. You know, is there anything that I can do? Yes, there's a lot you can do. Number one, relax completely. It's just a game, so to speak. You know, this is not life and death. If you miss a stroke, it's not going to kill you. I hope. So many people approach painting almost like they're playing Operation, where, you know, you got to get the little tweezers right on target, otherwise, you know. And it's not like that. It's really not. If you treat it like that, the hobby's not going to be fun for you. You're going to give up. You're going to quit. And you basically wasted your money and a bunch of time. So, number one, relax. Seriously relax. All right, number two, if you want some physical techniques, here's what you can do. Number one way to do it is relax your body, which I just said, but you got to relax mentally first. But if you want to relax mentally, you can tell your body to relax. And when your body relaxes, your brain will go, wait a minute, something's going on. My body's gotten loose. It's gotten relaxed. Maybe I need to kind of let go of things. So if you want your brain to follow what your body does, get your body to relax first. How do we do that? Take a couple of real nice deep breaths. Out through the mouth, not the nose. Breathe in through the nose, out through the mouth. Two or three times, not forcefully or anything. Preferably shut your eyes when you do it, just real nice and easy. And when you breathe out, drop your shoulders down and just feel like, almost like you've become like a rag doll, so to speak. Just let your whole body go limp. And that will loosen your body up and that will tell your brain, hey, it's time to relax. And you do that two or three times, and over that two or three breath period, your body will actually relax, your brain will kind of unwind a little bit, and that will help you to stop, you know, being so nervous about pain. Aside from that, best way to get your hands to stop shaking, number one, when you hold your miniature, let's say you're right-handed like I am, you're going to be holding your model on your left, take your hands, and you put them together, all right? That sort of forces your muscles together, and it'll keep your hands from shaking as much. Once you've done that, take your forearms and brace them on the table that you're painting against. All right? Now you've got a fairly stable surface to work with. Once you've done that, now you relax even further while you're painting. What you can do, if you're still having problems, now a lot of people don't have to deal with this, but some people do. If you're still having problems, paint only when you breathe out, okay? When you breathe in, it causes your chest cavity to come up a lot, and a lot of the times that will actually move your hands, okay? When you breathe out, there's a lot less movement that happens, plus you have that relaxation that goes on in your mind, and so your muscles relax and they're not as twitchy. Don't hold your breath, all right? Holding your breath is one of the worst things that you can do when you're painting. I know it feels like you're not moving at all, but when you hold your breath, you actually have these little microscopic muscle twitches, and it's really, really frustrating when you're trying to paint, okay? Just be very careful, be very calm, and breathe out, okay? This will actually slow your heart rate down too, which is a trick that archers and snipers use, because if your heart's pumping, what that does is it actually moves the muscles around your body, around your torso here. And so if you can slow your heart rate down, what you do if you're, let's say, an archer, you pull back, you breathe in, you breathe out, your heart thumps, thump, you release, and then your heart thumps again. All right? And so you end up basically doing all your work when there's no movement at all in your body. And that's what you do when you're painting. Now, as you progress and you get better, you can throw all that crap out the window because it's not going to be useful anymore. As you progress and as you get better, you can paint anytime, any way you want to. It doesn't really matter. You can paint upside down, not bracing your hands on anything. You can, you know, have your miniature set inside one of those helping hands things, and you can paint it like this. Whatever. You can breathe in while you're painting. You can breathe out. You can hold your breath. If you really want to do it, you can probably put your head underwater and do it. You know, there's tons of different things, but when you get started, those are just a couple of quick little tips and tricks that will help you stabilize your hands and keep your painting as non-mobile as you can do it. And that's basically the best that I can give you as far as being able to stabilize your hands, keep them from shaking, so that your painting techniques will become more smooth and come to you a lot more easily than they would otherwise. Anyway, hope you've enjoyed it today, guys. I know it's kind of a short video. What are we at? Oh, well, actually, it's fairly long, 9 minutes. But shorter than most of the Ask a Painters we've done recently. Anyway, that's it for today, guys. I hope you've enjoyed it. If you have any questions, feel free to put them in the comment section down below. And if you have any questions that you would like answered here on Ask a Painter, again, put those in the comment section down below. And if enough people want that question answered, it might be something we do here live on camera. Anyway, take care, everybody. Have a wonderful rest of the day. God bless you all, and I will see you all in the next video. Goodbye, everybody.